I'm here with Prudence Gordon, or Prue, from Asiti. Now, Prue, first of all, tell us about yourself and Asiti itself.
So, as you said, my name is Prue Gordon. I'm the Executive Director of Asiti. We are a relatively new organisation. We've been running full-time now for about 2 years. The whole purpose of Asiti is to create a place where people who work on and in international trade and investment can come together to discuss issues of national importance.
So my name is Cindy He. I'm in the industry and innovation team at ANZ Transaction Banking. So in this team, I look at emerging technologies and trends that are disrupting the world of global trade and supply chains, as well as global payments and liquidity management.
Private sector are pretty innovative. They're doing a lot of things, but they're also responding to what other governments are doing. A supply chain, of course, an international one, involves another party anyway. And so if Singapore's doing it, if Hong Kong's doing it, if London's doing it, then it's going to come back and affect us anyway. So we may as well be in front of that system, try to identify what's going to be coming down the track and be prepared for it and possibly lead it.
Well, XTC is a layer one that is sort of tackling a lot of trade finance issues. And also we're a real world asset tokenization platform. So we're also doing things like the paperless trade. We are pretty much on the forefront of real world asset and also payments on blockchain. We've noticed that there's been a strong push throughout the regions to export into MLETR regions. So we have onboarding agents in America that are working with us in India, Singapore, Dubai. We definitely have ways that Australian businesses can now integrate digitally and export paperless going forwards now to places like Singapore, UK, and the other MLETR regions.
So Lawrence, please tell us about ComGo and what it's all about.
So ComGo is a trade finance platform, multi-banked, and our main role is to facilitate the digitization of data between a bank and a corporate. My session in particular was about building trust, because the problem with digitization is you can't see the paper, you can't hold it in your hand, you can't stick it in your pocket, you can't do whatever. And so people need to be trusted that what they're seeing digitally is enforceable, it's genuine, can't change it easily, all those things.
So, Hari, please introduce your role and what you do here with the ANZ.
Sure. I head the industry and innovation function for our transaction banking business at ANZ. Transaction banking is trade and supply chain finance, payments, cash management, liquidity management, commodity finance. It's a big part of ANZ. And my role within that business is industry engagement, like what we do today. A lot of industry advocacy. I sit in a lot of industry boards. And innovation, which is bringing new and exciting propositions to our customers, such as digitizing trade. We don't see as much paper as we used to. That is because what is happening is that you have something which is created in a paper form, but in a computer, and then transmitted in that form through computers, through electronic channels. In some cases, depending upon which country you are exporting or importing from, that is printed out. But that is not truly digital. When we say truly digital, we are talking about data points as opposed to a PDF document, which can be machine readable. So that's the difference.
So Quantexa is a decision intelligence platform, so a technology company, which is a bit of a, lots of different buzzwords there, but essentially it's the use of different AI techniques to essentially enable better decisions and automate some of that decision process. In the trade world, we actually work with lots of global and local trade finance banks that are providing trade finance to essentially find the bad guys and to stop some of the fraud and money laundering that exists in some of those systems, but also work with governments as well and essentially do that same thing. So how can they use that context to understand where the bad actors might be in some of those systems?
This is not a standalone event. It builds off, we've done 12 webinars with the CD looking at the issues, but we absolutely want to take it forward to ensure that Australia gets better.
Over 130 people filled up the room, really exceeded expectations.
We're really pleased with the way this has come together. All of the speakers who were very willing to be part of it, the guests were clearly then an interested audience in it. We can tick off the boxes as we're on to something here. And the next question is, well, what do we do now?